Java. Oke. Alright, that's good, Shoban. Apa P ada masuk, Shoban? So, baru-baru nih. Ada P apa-apa yang masuk? Cukup makan. Ah, betul. Kalau no entry, no setup, better don't go, don't masuk. Ah, minggu lepas, yes. Minggu lepas ada a few P's, kan? Especially yen, pound yen cantik last week. I see pound yen kita, it went down until 200 over pips dari zone kita itu. Before I forget, kita punya link kan? Because we have some, apa nih? Nanti I share dalam Telegram. We have to shift to another link. Kan dia some technical punya things lah, huh? We have to do that. Nevermind, nanti dalam. We wait for a while. Dalam 5-6 minutes. We start. Why my? Kenapa my? Why got scratch? Huh? Why is Zoom punya apa ni? Got scratch ya? Funny. Shoban, minggu lepas apa pay yang masuk, Shoban? What's the pay yang you masuk? Minggu lepas tu. Okay. This week. Jiket. Oh, okay. Buy ya? Sell. Hi, Mr. Bradley. You are here? Okay, good. Cat still buy ya? Cat still buy. Fundamentally, they are a bit weak lah. From cat from apa ni BOC punya last week punya statement kan not that positive. We have RBNZ also last week possible type but now maybe there's a lockdown coming. We don't know how long punya rate hike punya apa ni projection. What's the projection? So a lot of US dollar sudah masuk pergi buy sell zone. Sorry. So we have to be careful there. Diorang masuk sell zone and if it bounce from there, then dia akan bounce this next few days where there is a lot of data coming out. Especially in the Eurozone kan, Eurozone dengan US, yes. So we look at the Eurozone. Okay, untuk tidak membuang masa, kita let us start. Okay, let us start with today's punya week ahead Monday live. Okay, let's see. Hi. Welcome to Monday Live. Okay. Monday Live, we are here to give week ahead punya trade ideas and bias for the week. We are a retails community, okay? And then I will share a few of our apa ni? Chat punya apa ni? Trade ideas as well, okay? And then we can still chat to each other, and then we just treat each other with respect here. And then let us help each other, kita tolong sama sendiri as a retailer to improve kita punya trading and profit. Okay, that's what we do. Okay, before we start, okay, let us see disclaimer. Wah, banyak garis dah. I don't know what happened to my apa nih, to my chart here ada garis-garis. Okay, never mind, but still can see kan. Okay, all the materials provided is for education and sharing purposes only. Does not contain investment advice. Trading forex, spot currency, stocks, and other securities involves substantial risk. There's always a potential for loss. Trading result may be vary. Only risk capital that you should use when trading. It's up to you as a trader on how to manage your risk capital. Should you decide to trade our method with your live account, we do not take any responsibility for any other unfavorable outcome. Okay. Hi. Okay. My name is Mr. B. Can call me Mr. B. I'm the chief currency strategist. Then chief coach untuk PX Trading Academy. Kita juga advice, okay, advice to traders and investors on apa yang what to invest and what to trade. And we don't provide trade signal, okay, not a trade signal. Kita we teach how to trade on your own better, okay. And then we provide some trade ideas, okay. And then we help traders to create trade plan. That is the main thing here. Okay. This week in the market, what is in the market? Kita news apa possible market mover for this week. We will look at kita punya economic data, punya what? Okay. Looking at this, kita ada flash. Sorry for the what? I don't know where this line come from. This apa nih? Line yang ini, nampak? I don't know where this come from. In my apa ni tak ada. I don't have. I'm not sure what happened to this slide here. Okay, anyway, as long as we can see, okay, this is flash manufacturing. Kita ada from US, Eurozone, and then Germany, and then of course UK. Okay, and then Aussie monetary policy minute. I don't think there's any changes from the last monetary policy, kan? And then ECB monetary policy statement, okay. Kita ada, I think tomorrow or the next day ada ECB monetary statement. We just have to look at apa diorang punya bias on that. We are at the very in a buy zone now, kan? Dalam euro punya apa ni, euro USD. So there's a possibility kalau ada some hawkish statement, okay, it could move from there, okay. So we just have to look at the price then dalam kita punya Telegram though. Okay. And then retail sales for Canada and UK. Okay. Last week summary kita strengthen US. Okay, US strengthen with positive data on CPI semua. So that's why we are looking at US dollar kan. Sekarang is strong going up. Okay. And then over the weekend kita ada OPEC. Okay, last week kita ada OPEC which agreed to a plan to increase production for like 400k barrels per day kan by the end of year or in the end of the year. So we might see there's something they I don't know what happened guys, but ada some drawing here. Yeah. Got any idea where this come from? Drawing me. Let me check with technical first. Let me check with technical first. Okay. Nothing we can do. I still don't know where this come from. Yang garis kuning semua nih dengan garis merah. Okay. So we have flash manufacturing. Sorry. Okay, flash manufacturing. Kita tengok, we go and see kita punya. Where is my? Oh, there's something there. Okay, hold on. Kita pergi Ferrex Factory dulu. Okay. So this week, this is the possible market mover. Okay. Kita ada, okay, tonight we have, tadi kita ada MPC, okay. This is GBP punya lah. Tomorrow morning, 9:30, kita ada monetary policy, which I don't expect any change on the Aussie punya monetary policy. And then the punya retail sales is, that's why you Aussie today, you looking at Aussie kan, dia jatuh kan. Because they are pricing it for tomorrow also, okay. Expecting to be maybe dovish lah from or neutral lah from Aussie punya bank, okay, RBZ ya, yeah. Okay, and then another one is this one. Tomorrow US crude oil inventory expecting 7.9 million. Ini akan impact on CAT juga, okay? CAT is very far up now. I think it's going for the weekly. Okay. ECB monetary statement on Thursday. Oh, Thursday will be moving. Thursday, and then there's nothing much here. It's only on Thursday here. Kan nampak ECB. This is on monetary policy. And then Friday is the one yang paling paling meriah. Okay, we got retail sales at 2, and then manufacturing flash manufacturing PMI ya. For euro from 3 until euro ni sampai 4. So it's going to be very meriah lah here. If the data coming out besar dari yang ini 58.1 and besar dari 59 ataupun as apa ni sama dengan 59, we will see euro lah. Euro yang apa ni menguat lah. Alright, we will see euro menguat from here. So at the moment, okay, it's in a buy zone. We are waiting for a reaction from the apa ni US dollar. US dollar also very very up very up di atas sekarang. So this will move the market for this week. Okay, even US pun ada dia punya, okay, dia punya flash manufacturing PMI nampak. Okay, it's stronger. Kebanyakan ni is lower. Tengok previous forecast dia lower semua. Lower. Okay. So if market is pricing in, they gonna pricing from today until Friday means euro is going to be weak lah until data ni keluar. Data keluar then we know better. We see how. But we are in a small buy zone lah. Is in the buy zone. Nanti kita tengok the chart. Kita tengok the chart. So we have also retail sales for GBP kan on Friday as well. Semua pun action is on Friday most of it. During the weekdays not so much. Okay, but we have to just be aware saja. Tengok-tengok apa-apa ada apa ni? Apa sentiment ada around? Tiba-tiba somebody talk about this, somebody talk about that, then the apa ni? Currency punya direction also change. Alright, this is core retail sales on Friday Canada. Dia belum ada forecast. Okay, so far it's dovish. It's very bearish for CAT lah. Lagipun kalau US CAT, you look at US CAT, dia punya we are at from support kan going up. Might do corrections, okay, before getting strong, and at the same time, oil kan, crude oil, because CAT and oil is satu, we pack the the currency peg for oil is kept. Also kan dalam satu sell zone. We can look at it later. We can look at it later. Kan nanti kita tengok. Okay. Go back here. Okay, hilang sudah the line this now. That's good. Okay. Trade ideas. What is the chart suggesting? Nah, kita tengok apa chart. Okay. You have any chart that you want to suggest? Mau tengok kan? We can look at it. For now, trade ideas of the week kita will look at USDX, Euro index, and then maybe pound, pound USD, and then Aussie USD especially lah. I will look at Aussie USD, kan? And then gold lah, itu yang paling laku, paling ramai orang. Okay, we look at US index. Where is my US index tadi? Okay, I think I erase it. Never mind. Okay, kita pergi trading view. Trading view, trading view. Okay. Look at the dollar index, huh? Ngam-ngam dalam sell zone kita nih. Ngam-ngam dalam sell zone. Nampak ah? So might have somewhat lah. But dalam sell zone ni, yeah, it's quite what actually. Kalau dia mau buat pull, kalau dia mau kuat, dia terus kuat. Kalau dia mau buat pullback, then we will see some pullback from here. But on the higher time frame actually, if you look at US index, on the higher time frame, see, dia tengah buat correction besar ni. You see that? We are from a we are from this zone. A few times bounce and then up, bounce and then up. So so far there, for me, I'm still long term bearish on US lah. Okay, for some fundamental reason lah. Saya masih long term bearish on US dollar, but waiting for a good sales area. The best will be here lah, the 50%. Nampak ni green zone lah. Green zone is the price retracement zone for those who just join. Price retracement zone for the Fibonacci. Okay, kita ambil golden ratio dia 50% at least. Okay, this is the long termnya. At the moment dia memang dalam satu sell zone buy, sell zone for daily. It might do a pullback. Okay, and then we don't have a long term direction for now on the fundamental kan, kita go day by day. Here already bridge, nampak every time dia masuk kita punya zone merah ni dia pull back sikit, dia masuk zone merah ni dia pull back. This two already fill up, huh? So it's already fill up, so no more orders sini, orders left here. Ini nampak gap ni, ada a bit gap here. We go and look at, but if we look daily at a gap, look at H4, I don't know whether no gap or not. No gap. No gap, huh? Okay. Tapi yang penting punya apa ni, is here at 93,100 and yang ini sini, 93,200 lah. Make it 93,200. This is where we can, silap. Di sini yang kita boleh tengok. Ni. Hold on. Make it a big round number, we got it. 93,200. Alright. Senang kan? Macam tu. Okay. Itu tempat-tempat yang kita kena monitor this next few days. Okay. Buffer. Up till here lah. Sini stop kita. Dia lepas ni, okay, that will be a danger zone for most of the what. We see first, dia lepas, ada sini. Actually, there's one here. But this is the last one before it go down lah. Kalau dia mau guna semua order yang di dalam tu, dia bagi tembus, dia pergi this one. 936, make it 65. We see kalau 650. Okay, that's kita punya alert. Okay. Dia di atas. Oh, itu sudah guna pula. Sorry ya. Ini sudah guna. Sorry. Nampak? Yang ini jatuh from here. I didn't realize that. Meaning, yang sini punya order ni, when it jatuh kan, it took from here. So, this level won't be that strong anymore. Okay. We take it out. Okay. Kita guna level yang ini saja. Hai Otai, baru nampak. Ini dalam trading view. Ya, ini dalam trading view, Otai. Ah, ini dalam trading view. Saya guna dalam trading view ya. Clear lah ini kan. Nah, ini nampak. Otai nampak kan, Otai? Trading view. Kita pergi cari DXY. Ah, kita cari US dollar punya index. Ah, kita cari DXY ya. Boleh, Otai? Ataupun kalau kita masuk trading view, kita tinggal di US dollar index saja. Oke, okay? US dollar index. Nampak otak ya? Oke ya? Oke. So, oke. Okay. Yes, ini this is inilah kita punya dua line ini. Nah, kita tengah monitor yang dua ini. But zone kita yang ini ya, buffer zone kita yang ini. I think most of kita punya apa ni, kita punya pace pun is very near to a buy and a buy zone kebanyakan. Kecuali US CAD lah, US CAD it went up very far, dia tembus kita punya zone. We look at the chart, kita tengok chart satu-satu, okay? Okay, nampak Euro USD also in a buy, nampak ni? Ah, this is a buy here. Daily buy ya, this one daily buy. But in the higher time frame, nah dia masih ada tempat-tempat tertentu yang dia might boleh pergi lah. But for now, I will hold my buy here. Ini zone ni, this zone ah. I will hold my buy. Buffer not so much. Buffer around 100 pips lah, 100 pips okay lah. For a daily kan, 100 pips should be okay. Kita tengok level-level yang penting ah inside ah. Okay, hold on. Kita tengok level-level penting for euro. Okay, ini apa? What level is this? It's somewhere here. Oh, not so much ah here. But dalam zone inilah dia punya apa ni? Dia punya what not so tidak berapa menarik, okay? Tapi this in this zone ah, this zone daily. We are looking at this, okay? Possible bounce from here, possible bounce from here. Buffer only like 100 pips. Okay, kita tunggu di lower time frame. I think most of dia punya apa ni is in our kita punya. Dalam kita punya Telegram, dalam Telegram group. We look at H1. What can we see H1? Normally kita cari dia punya pointnya, point for it to terbang. Point dia terbang tu penting. Point dia terbang dari mana? Dari sini. Sini sudah guna hari itu. Means this zone accumulating is quite what. But the daily accumulating is interesting. This drop, base, rally. Dua kali. Dua base ini. Drop, base, rally. Okay. The reason kenapa we can buy this is because of this guy saja sekarang. because of US dollar index, dia dalam sell zone, satu sell zone. Okay. We look at the daily. Yep. Yep. Nah, there daily. Ah, yeah. This sell zone here. Okay. There's possibility for it to bounce. Huh? Okay, sini dia fill, then we can cut it off. Fill, we cut it off. Okay. Fill, we cut it off. Nah, sini we got buy. Fill, we cut it off. Hari itu kita ada buy euro from here also kan. So we are waiting. So it's gonna be quite bumpy ride lah, because diorang kena clear kan this daily punya order kan. So we expect dia ada a few times up, bounce, up, bounce, up, bounce. Kalau betul-betul dia mau jalan terus, dia akan turun for retracement, possible retracement to this zone. Kita tengok price action ya, then baru kita masuk. This is the level yang kita sedang monitor lah on the US dollar. Yep. 6. Otai dapat otai ya? Kena? Okay. So, US dollar, euro dollar, sekejap. Nanti kita tengok. There's a higher time frame punya I want to share with you guys today nanti. Okay, it's more on apa ni? More on longer term punya lah. Euro dengan gold lah. Okay, there are something here also. Are we waiting here? Kalau sini tembus then kita tunggu di bawah ni. Okay. One of the best prices will be somewhere here. Ini cantik. Okay, cantik. One of the best price lah untuk nak tunggu. If you want to wait for them. Okay. Alright, next. Kita tengok Aussie USD. Okay. Dia pun dekat dengan this Aussie USD daily. Ya. Very near to this zone here. So, a level yang saya monitor is somewhere around 0.7300 ni. I wait for them here. Sampai sini then we will monitor. Because at the moment US memang on the way up untuk clear order, sell order di atas tu. After clearing only maybe they will go down. That is how kita tengok kita punya chart lah. Okay, on the chart itself. So it's no action yet at the moment. Lagipun the moment the FOMC hari itu, dia memang on a downtrend. Yes. For this Aussie USD. Yes. Higher time frame, weekly dia di sini. Okay. Correction, I'm not sure. Okay, tapi dia memang dalam satu area rollover. This is rollover. Tap, sini resistant, and then from here, dia, from this zone here, baru diorang naik. Nampak, from this zone here. So, as usual, kita punya color for significant support or significant resistance will be yang ini. Nampak. Okay. So this is our big buy zone for the weekly. Dari 7300 sampai 71700. Okay, 0.71700. Okay. Besar ni. Buffer around 100 over pips, okay. Around 100 over pips should be okay. Kalau dia mau naik, dia naik from here. Okay. Yes. Yep. Tapi dia mungkin akan main-main from here first. Here, guna order naik sikit. Order ambil naik sikit. Order ambil naik sikit. Baru ada sentiment, baru dia naik habis. So far, yes. Because US dollar, long term lah, but not now. Long term, kan, it's more on a bearish side for US dollar index, okay, for this long term. We will see at okay, ini pun kita tengok. Kenapa kita tengok euro US Aussie? Because dalam plus I let you know, guys know kan, kalau Aussie USD bearish, okay, euro USD bearish, okay, euro Aussie akan bullish. Nampak? This is the market correlation-nya. So dia sekarang dalam satu sell zone juga, okay? Daily sell zone. It might main di sini dulu sebelum dia turun sikit. So they, if they clear, if dia orang mau clear order sini semua ni, they have to be around here. Sana lah banyak manipulation. Eh, sorry, this is merah 600 lah. Maybe you put 600 semua. 600 by 600. We look at 600, kita tengok dia punya. Oh, jauh pula. Oh, 600 bawah. Okay, 61 lah. Oh, 65. Kita tengok. 65 is here already. Tengok H4 ada apa. We look at H4. Oh, 65 dulu. Oh, sini ada. 61 lah. Ngam-ngam 61. Okay. Why I put this level is this is the level where ada macam ni rally base drop kan, there's a decision dia dari sini and then dia turun. Nampak ni candlestick yang ni, yang masuk cluster tu faham lah, is less is more, kecil dia tu, less is more. What is less is more? Dia accumulate price di sana time itu before dia jalan buat satu pergerakan besar. Otai yang itu faham atau ya? Candlestick kecil, lepas itu ada satu candlestick besar, nampak? Yes. So, sini ada order. This is one of the order 1.6100. Untuk kita sell Aussie USD. Nah, sekarang mulai tengah bounce sikit, but I think it will play around here dulu. Sebelum dia. Apa-apapun we see what is the US dollar doing. Kalau US dollar start turun, ini pun start turun. Okay? Then these two start naik. These two will start going up. We look at the lower time frame, kita boleh masuk sana. As usual lah, kita ikut SOP semua tu. Kan? Ada SOP kan? In a lower time frame, just follow that SOP. I think that should be safe already. Okay, okay. Gold pun mau tengok kan? Okay, what happened to gold? Kan, dia turun daripada yang ini biasa drop, best drop during the class last week. I share ini memang zone dia untuk sell. Nampak? This drop, best drop. Nampak? This is the sell zone. This is where it sells off from. Okay, we are near the green zone. Apa dia green zone? Okay, dia tengah buat apa ni? Rejection. But I don't think that fast lah. Oi, kuat pula, kan? Lower time frame lah. Sudah buat reversal. Tengah buat reversal. Tapi dia belum sampai. 95 or 96 sampai. Oh, ada satu area kan? I mark 97 somewhere there. Ada satu area, I guess. Here. This one, this zone. Here until here. The bounce. Ada order lah. Rally best, rally apa? See ya? Rally, this best, rally apa? It's bouncing from there, tapi dia sudah guna lah. Okay, 97 and 96. But I would prefer kalau dia sampai bawah ni. Sampai bawah sini ni, 78 ni. Because ini zone dia, ini zone nampak ni, Ah, ini zone tempat dia. Ah, tempat dia buat apa nih? R become support. Ah. Tapi order, yang ada order itu masih yang fresh still is this one lah. Ah, this one here lah. Yang ini sudah kena ambil, but maybe still got orders lah. You still can use. Bullish engulfing yang mana itu? Otai, yang biru nih. Ya, yeah, this is bullish engulfing. Ya, yeah, itu bullish engulfing. Sebelum di neck. Hari itu ada buy from here kan? Yes, ini bullish engulfing besar nih. Tapi at the moment, we wait for price to come in here. Okay. This is my mark zone, 1.788. Mungkin akan naik. But the only problem with this is, kan, last few days dia ada buat satu reversal. If we look at this, kan, dia ada buat reversal. Nampak ni three candle ni. Apa ni? MOAR. Dick, are you there, Dick? Nampak lah. 1, 2, 3, Otay. Apa dia buat? Itulah. Dia tengah buat mother of all reversal tu. Ah, here. This one lah. Yeah. Nampak ni? What's this? Start ni. 1, 2, 3. This three lah. This three candle lah. Selalu ambil yang, okay, yang last satu. And then the first candle, mana? Itu balance dia tu, dia punya candlestick tu. Nampak? Okay. So, mother of all reversal. Itu pasal dia push down kuat tu today. And the same time, of course, US dollar kuat lah. Going up, kan? But we wait dekat sini. Yang ni green zone ni, apa tu? Kita tengok sukatan, very simple. A, B, nampak? A, B, this is our C lah. Okay, possible, this is price retracement zone. Okay, for those yang baru join, okay, green zone tu, tempat Fibonacci golden ratio lah. Kita ambil 50 and 61.8. Because of dia punya risk-reward rate. Okay, risk-reward. Ini TP1 kita sini, TP2 kita di atas ni. Okay, if possible dia naik lah from here. But we still wait lah, we still waiting for this lah. Kalau dia mau naik ni, US kena drop first. Yes, the US dollar index kena drop. Then we will see an upside on here. Alright. Okay, on the daily, dia baru touch the yellow. Weekly dia belum touch anything on the MA. Nah, waiting for it to touch here MA 1790 or 1780 something here. Nih. Nah, kalau dia touch ini ada besar kemungkinan akan buat bounce. Okay. Also I think near the green zone 17. Yep, lebih kurang dekat dengan green zone juga. Here lah. At hold on lah weekly ya. Oh, 90 sini. Sini at 3. Lebih kurang at 5 lah. Okay, sini at 8. Lebih kurang this zone lah. It might bounce up. For now, it's not advisable untuk kita buy masuk entry here. Okay, it's not advisable. For me, I don't. Saya tidak masuk sana. Saya tidak akan masuk. Time-time dia macam ni. Time dia busy ni. Tengah positioning. Boleh scout lah. Kalau mau scout, boleh scout. Okay. So, kita ada yang ini. So, kalau dia tembus yang ini, berarti it's going down to our not this one. Going down to kita punya sell zone sini, nih, daily ini. This one lah. Okay, if tembus here, possible dia ada tempatnya. I think dalam chat I did mention here 1748 ah. 1748 ya. Yeah. 1748. Okay, somewhere here. Okay, this is what we are going to. We going to wait untuk buy ya. Okay, going to wait. Beside here lah. Yeah. Ini cantik because dia ngam-ngam juga dekat. If you look at this, dia ngam-ngam at. Kita punya daily punya. Baru kita break kan. Ngam-ngam kita punya daily punya. Ambil body lah. Okay. Like the body and then the price. Lebih kurang macam ni lah. That's the whole idea lah sekarang. Nah, tempat dia roll reversal. Tempat dia roll over lagi. Resistance become support ya. Okay ya. tunggu ngom dekat weekly punya anu lah. This is our alert lah ya. Yeah. MA 55 and MA yang biru ni ya. MA low, MA 5 low, linear weighted, yes, okay, linear weighted. Okay, so far, faham? Ada yang mau ditanya apa-apa? You can tanya me. Otai, ada apa-apa yang tidak faham? Semua okay ya? Oh, hi Alex. Baru nampak kamu. Cucu pokle ya, ada di. Asri ada apa-apa mau tanya? Asri, you can ask apa-apa pay yang you want to. Oh, you want to look at Ponyen kan? Asri, Ponyen ah?
Ya, yes, saya sekarang tengah observe lagi. observing baru rookie.
Okay, it's okay. Boleh tanya. Don't worry. Kita dalam satu this is a daily buy zone, okay? But kita cek in the lower time frame. Ponyen baru sampai loh, baru sampai deh. Hari itu kita punya Ponyen dari sini kita buat deh. Around 300 over pips dah down. But because of what kan? Because dia di satu. Dia come out from a very resistant on a weekly basis. So dia tengah buat correction ni. Kuat buat correction dia. Nampak ah, Sri ya? In a lower time frame,
okay. Kan,
we can cari buy if we want to, but this buy is quite dangerous because momentumnya tengah kuat. Nampak?
Okay.
Momentumnya tengah kuat. We look at the H4. Oh, H4, there's no good apa nih? Not very good base lah Sri for me. Daily yes. Tapi dia tengah kuat momentum dia turun ni. It's not advisable for you to go in at the moment.
Jadi buy temporary buy sajalah.
Ini kalau buy temporary buy, but it's sekarang ni dia tengah momentum market tengah turun semua ni. Dia tengah sell off. Pound and yen tengah kuat sekarang. Nampak?
Okay.
Dia tengah sell off pound, yen tengah kuat. But if you want to buy, you kena cari di lower time frame, temporary buy. Because okay, kalau kita tengok sekarang ni, okay. If you want to buy, okay, dia dari sini ke sini kan? Berapa pip dia jalan? 160 over pip. Okay, if you want to buy intraday a pullback punya buy, you can always buy selepas dia sampai dia punya daily range tu. Berapa daily range? 100 and 100 and 100 117. Sudah lebih ya dari trading range ya, Asri. So they must have some apa nih? Sentiment punya. Wow, what happened to my chat? Hold on lah. Okay. They must ada sentiment punya hak yang from here. Hold on. Hari ini ya, today. Today itself jalan pun sudah turun berapa? 160, yes. So dia sudah sampai buy zone nih. It's not you have to wait in the lower time frame for a reversal before you can enter. But at the moment momentum dia memang kuat untuk mau clear all the orders here. Me, I won't enter at the moment because market tengah sell off. Kita cari setup tempat lain nih. This one is not a very good setup at the moment. Because semua time frame pun tidak nampak clear setup. Nampak nih, tidak clear setup. There's no clear setup. Kita boleh take a pullback lah. Hari itu sudah ambil yang ini, nah, nampak. Sekarang dia tembus yang sini. No, I don't see any pullback. 149,800. Mark the point. Ini. Monitor, ada reversal, then we can consider masuk. If you want to buy. Tapi buy cannot be long. Jangan lama sangat buy. Because momentum kuat turun nih. Semua selling. Yeah. Nampak Asri?
Okay, nampak. Baru je tengok you tunjuk chart dah baru nampak dia tengah kuat sell.
Itu pasal. Dia
tadi je buy sekejap saja. Sampai news keluar terus dia turun.
Betul. Betul. So at the moment, momentum memang turun. Dari hari itu kita punya setup kan, kita punya apa ini trade setup memang turun. Because of the higher time frame because of higher time frame dia mau buat correction. Nampak Asri? Dia sudah lama aja kan? Dia betul. Memang mau buat correction nih.
What goes up must come down jugalah kan?
Yes, what goes up have to come down, but dia come down sampai mana? Kita kena tunggu dari sini bawah. But if you want to, if you are a bear, kan? If you are a bearish punya trader, kita tunggu dia baliklah. Kita tunggu dia pull back, then we re-entry sell di atas tu. Kita re-entry sell dekat. Okay, this is one whole what kan? Dari sini ke sini. Kita cari order dia. Kawasan order dia semua tu. Okay. So we have two. We have one here. And we have one here. But if we want to sell back lah. Kalau kita ikut higher time frame punya what? We supposed to sell. Sell is light pink. Kenapa gray tu? I think. Satu, dua. This is the zone that I will sell. This is the two area I will sell. But at the moment, kan, because hold on, otai. At the moment, dia memang pergerakan dia not quite limited because memang belum season untuk dia pergi jauh lah. So it's going intraday. Okay, intraday is the best setup for now. Candle bullish E and bearish E boleh dirujuk untuk create idea of market trend. Engulfing. Boleh. Okay. Apply tapi dia kena ada dia punya sebab kenapa dia mau masuk. Trendline macam MA, BB kalau dah set dalam tiap-tiap P macam mana mau save supaya tak perlu repeat. Kamu pergi sini juga. Otai tengok ah kalau kamu mau save kan kamu kena pergi save template sini. Bila kamu sudah save template sini, kamu letaklah apa kamu mau letak GBP JPY. Okey, macam ini GBP JPY kan. Okey. Kamu masuk sini. Okey, save template. Okey, GBP JPY. Okey, Otai. Save ah. Okey, saya save ah. Nanti next time kalau saya mau cari GBP JPY, kamu pergi new chart. Kan, kamu cari GBP JPY, nampak? Dia baru kan? Okey. Then kamu balik sini, kamu cari GBP JPY, kamu punya setup masih ada, nampak? Ah, dia tidak lari. Dia masih di sana intact. Oke ya. Kamu masuk sini saja save template nih. Oke, okay, ya. Oke, okay, itu bullish engulfing and bearish engulfing boleh rujuk, can rujuk, tapi you kena cari dia mesti keluar daripada satu zone. Meaning dia keluar dari satu zone yang besar. Oke, okay, contoh. Oke. Okay. Ah ini. Ini bullish engulfing, dia pergi satu zone, dia pergi ambil order saja. Dia bukan keluar dari zone. Ah, kalau dia keluar dari zone you kena cari yang engulfing dia macam ni kah? Macam ni. Bullish. Lepas tu baru dia naik. Tapi dia naik tidak jauh lah. Okay. Dia keluar from this buy zone. Dia engulfing. Then you can buy. Around 100 over peak. Nampak kah? Okay. Okay. That's the one. For now. JPY. Okay. If you want to buy Asri. Dia sini buy. Sini kita punya next TP ya, around 90 pips. Boleh ya, Asri? Deh.
Okay, set.
Alright. Dia punya buffer quite big lah actually, around okay juga, around 60-70 pips. H4 okay. This is our end of kita punya buffer. Kan? Yes. This is the setup for GBP/JPY. Okay, one interesting before we end kita punya nongkan. One interesting wala, very interesting punya long term punya setup ah. I see kan. Okay, this is Euro USD ah, long term ah. For those yang lama sudah ikut saya since 2017-18. Okay, this is what we saw kan. Okay, ini yang kita nampak hari itu in gold. Nampak? Nah, what happened to gold? It's the more or less same setup. Nampak? Euro USD pun same setup. Because long term, okay, long term for Euro is for me is still bullish and USD is bearish. That is fundamental reason untuk fundamental reason. Gold pun sama. Okay, gold pun sama. Si nampak, dia naik. That's it. So untuk gold kalau dia turun lagi jauh sini, lagi cantik lah this one, 159 something. Kan? We look at the level, apa level dia tu sana? Lebih kurang dalam Fibonacci level, apa ini golden ratio lah di sana. Nampak? If we pull from the down, okay. So this is an interesting setup ah, I see. From the down lebih kurang. This one. Nampak? This one and Euro ah, Euro just starting. Baru dia break. Dia break trend line ni. Dia tengah turun ni. Okay. Mungkin dia akan main here for a few months ah before it go up just like this one ah. See? Yes. Baru dia naik. Nah, this is a long term setup lah, long term setup. Because kalau long term setup for those yang mau swing, mau cari swing, ah, this will be a nice setup pace. Okay, mau cari swing. For now, oh, kita ada around 100 over pips buffer. Kalau if we go to the lower time frame, yeah, see, tengah reject nih. What happened to US dollar? Draw body to body candle. Saya kurang paham kok punya soalan nih, oke? Okay? Itu Fibo kalau draw body to body. Body to body meaning macam mana itu, Otay? Pasal Fibo selalu kok tarik dari satu. Oh, you mean body dia, bukan dia punya wick. Bukan dia punya apa nih? Atas tuh, itu kah, Otay? Selalu kita ambil the lowest point lah. Pasal Fibo ini, it's just for us to, apa nih, Fibo ini just for us to agak-agak tempat itu saja. Okay? But, apa macam pun, kita kena cari tempat yang ada order itu. Ingat, Fibo. Okay? Tempat yang ada order yang penting. Ya, itu penting. Tempat yang ada order itu yang kita mau cari. Bukan tempat Fibo itu kita hanya tarik untuk kita punya reference saja. Reference saja. Untuk reference kita saja. So, okay, nampak ini market. Market is compressing. Berarti dia tengah apa ini position untuk mau buy ini. Di mana buy? Kita one of our apa ini is sini lah. Kan? At the moment, this is the daily buy zone. Tapi kalau dia mau ambil liquidity di bawah lagi, dia can go. But buffer is quite small lah. Buffer berapa sih ini? 870-80 untuk daily is small. Yes, because daily normally is 100 over pips. Okay. This is the. But this one is for monthly ya. I share this untuk monthly. So that we go, kita ada bias yang long term bias. Okay, long term bias just like this one. Okay, my long term bias pun sama, masih sama. But dia punya movement masih di sini lah. This is the kita punya first level of consolidation. Dia ada 3 levels . This is our level of consolidation. Okay, I think ada apa-apa mau tanya lagi? Any P yang we want to look at? Wah, jam 9 sudah. Okay, before that, let me go through kepada yang baru join us. Okay, kita. Oh, mother of all candlestick. Otay, MOAR. Mother of all candlestick. Nanti kamu tengok tu candlestick pattern tu. Dalam kamu punya apa ni notes. Kan? Mother of all candlestick. Kamu tengok tu candlestick pattern punya notes. Okay, before that, I just want to briefly tell apa what strategy we are using here. Okay, untuk people like Asri kan? Asri just joined. Okay, what is BB strategy? This is strategy yang kita guna. Kita panggil dia the big boy strategy. Okay. Dalam kelas Asri, you have to join itu kelas. Kelas kita every first week and second week of the month. First week and second week of the month. Okay. At the moment nanti we will let you know. Kan? First week and second week of the month. Next few weeks ada. Next 2 weeks ada kelas lagi. Next 2 weeks ada kelas lagi. Alright. Okay, I just tell you apa strategi that we are using at the moment so that you can have some ideas. Boleh ya? Asri? This big boy strategy, okay, kita based on price action and then kita cari tempat buy and sell. Okay, the mana market will bounce. Okay, itu yang kita cari. Using only naked chart and to find potential entry levels. Of course, kita ada a few more confirmers like indicator semua we use, but that one is in the class. I will explain more. Okay, three simple steps, very easy. Kita identify saja, kita cari. Okay, macam juga kita hunting, memburu, scanning, and mapping the chart. Okay, kita mark zone, kita tunggu, then kita only enter bila kita di zone. Kenapa? Because kita tahu dalam zone tu dia ada sell ataupun buy order. Kita kalau bank buy, kita buy. Kalau bank sell, kita sell. Itu simple. Okay, like this one. Look at this. Simple one. Okay, merah sell, biru buy. As simple as that. Okay, sampai merah, kita sell. Nampak kena sikit biru, dia bounce. Okay, sampai biru pula yang bawah tu. Okay, this is the first one. Yang bawah tu. Okay, nampak bawah tu. Sampai biru yang bawah tu. Okay, we stop selling. Then we start buying. Nampak dia bounce balik ke atas. Yes, kita cari zone-zone macam tu. So this is the before. Jadi sebelum lagi market berlaku, sebelum movement berlaku, we already mark zone supaya kita boleh anticipate macam yang ini. Jadi dari merah kita sell, dari biru kita buy. That's all. Actually, apa dia big BB zone tu, big boy zone is kita panggil dia actually order flow of the bank, okay? Di mana diorang letak diorang punya liquidity, okay? Untuk diorang bergerak besar ataupun panjang, jauh diorang gerak ataupun besar punya apa ini movement. Selalu macam ada news semua kan kita nampak. Kita tengok. Low risk. Dia bukan low risk. Yang low tu yang saya letak dekat kita punya apa ni kan? Low tu low probability atau medium probability. Dalam kita punya chart kan selalu ada low kan. Kalau low probability means zone itu, okay? It's low probability untuk buy ataupun kita sell. Yes. Kalau medium, dia masih medium. Kalau high probability, itu cantik. Selalu high probability, I will use warna kuning. You can scroll up and scroll up balik dalam some of the apa ni? The some notes juga di dalam. Kalau ada apa yang tidak faham, nanti time class you can. Oh, every Monday kita ada Monday live kan? You can ask me on Monday live for now. Before the class. Okay, Asriya. Okay, order flow. Okay, what is true in the market? Market is always right lah. Okay, market kita tidak boleh control. Okay, biggest player in the market siapa? The big banks ataupun also known as the big boys. That's why we use this big boys BB strategy. Okay, they control 80% of the liquidity in the currency market. This is the logic here. Never go against the big banks. Okay, kenapa? Okay. Because they have the liquidity. Like us retailers, kita hanya ada berapa? Maybe liquidity of 10%, 500 billion. 500 billion bukan sikit. The whole market can reach up to 6. Over trillion dollar. I think sekarang sudah naik. Because 6.7 trillion is somewhere in 2018-19 data. Okay, I think now should be around somewhere around 7-8 trillion, especially no pandemic, lagi ramai orang masuk market. Okay, what moves the market? Ini penting. Follow the leader. How to find when we not follow shark? Betul, betul. Pandai ya Sri. Ngam. Okay, sentiment and fundamental yang move the market. Okay, macam news, economic, data pandemic all. And another thing that move the market yang sometimes yang jarang orang faham is the price. This is where the big banks main diorang punya role. Okay, they will look at mana diorang mau buy, mana diorang mau sell, which is they call it buy low, sell high punya tempat di mana diorang boleh buat untung. Okay, 95 traders lose money cause of lack of information. Most of the time, lack of information. Okay. How do bank trade forex? Ini penting. Bank manage forex transaction juga untuk klien orang. Okay, mostly using fundamental analysis and for long trade position. Okay, why? Because orang ada liquidity satu kan, so they can use this swing trade position senang. And then they make profit. Okay, in two ways. Bank buat profit two ways. Satu orang act as a bank. Okay, act as a dealer for client. Satu lagi dia generate profit from the as a speculator macam kita lah. as a retail trader. Sama juga macam kita, the only problem is, the only thing yang diorang ada kelebihan is because diorang ada liquidity. Okay, they have liquidity. Alright? Okay. Bank usually uses 80% of fundamental analysis, 80%. Okay, this is where you don't go against the central bank, because central bank is the policy maker, diorang yang buat semua supply demand in of the currency in the market. So we just follow the central bank, and then secondly 20% technical analysis diorang guna. So dalam diorang punya technical analysis, there are not so much, so many indicators, because technical for bankers is based on price level. That's why we are going to we use that price level punya advantage from the bank as well. Okay, macam ni. Look at this. This is a forex orders at 0.6525. Ada 1 billion lah, nampak? 1 billion. What will happen kalau dalam level, at this level bila price sampai sana? Okay, look at this. Nampak? Okay, this is what happened. It bounce back. Bila dia ada 1 billion order, dia bounce back. So when the bank got this much order, 1 billion, we also buy. Kita ikut buy. Kita follow the leader. Okay, how does it look like in the chart? It's very simple. I think some of you very familiar with this. Okay, it's kita ada bullish. Bullish is buy, base. Ataupun kita ada bearish base. Okay, this is the big boys base. Okay, I call it tempat refueling station. Okay, di mana when rally base rally dalam base ini actually what they do is they are accumulating all the orders before diorang jalan. So bila jalan, when they accumulate the price, okay, untuk buy, the buy orders masih ada yang tinggal lagi. So every time bila dia naik, bila dia turun balik, okay, that's why they ada bounce. Sometimes they bounce from there, okay, because they still buy, ada buy orders ini. By the time dari atas kan turun, dia bounce, dia we just follow them buy. Same goes here, bullish base, drop base, rally. This is very simple punya. It's more on supply demand lah. Supply demand, but they are more into it. Nanti kita in like Astri, you can join the class, then you can get the better idea nanti ya. Better idea. And then bearish base for sell, drop base drop. Then another one is rally base drop. Itu sih yang kita cari actually. Dia semua ada di sana di chart. Nampak? Bila price turun dari sini, kita nampak rally base drop. Rally base drop itu apa? Rally base drop itu RBD itu sell. Bearish kan? Nah, nampak. Bila price sampai, dia turun. Nampak? Bila ini drop, nampak? Drop, dia buat base rally. Apa? Drop base rally itu. Drop base rally yang ini. Okay. Buy ya. Okay. Bila naik, turun lah. Bila naik. Nampak? Bila price sampai tempat ini, kita ikut sama buy. Itu saja kita mau cari actually. Way or okay. That's good, Asri. Indicator of news when to buy or sell. If news, we also not quite sure, but we use the price action saja, Asri. Kita guna price action untuk kita mau cari buy or sell. Normally, sometimes news kan, it will go on the opposite side. That's where price take over actually. But for the news, okay, we can look at the news. Apa macam we just have to kumpul more data, then we can basically get the news punya insight lah, macam tu. But price will always move from the zones. This big place selalu diorang akan move from the zone. Okay, I think you can understand kan, Asri? I think you already study juga SND semua ni kan. It's just that which base yang kuat, which base yang not that strong. The one I think we have to find out there. You can join the class for that. Mana base yang kuat and mana base yang not strong enough. that we like okay, like just now kan kita punya poniendo kan. Okay, sih nampak dia sampai saja kita punya apa ni, sampai saja kita punya marking tu. Nampak tu ya, it bounce. Kenapa dia bounce ni? Ah, 149,800. Kenapa dia bounce ni? Ah, because ada character dia punya candlestick here. Ah, dia rally best rally. Biarpun sini busy zone, okay. And this dalam kelas ni, this is what we call less is more. Less is more punya candlestick. Ah, so it will at least sampai level it will bounce. Dia bounce terus. Ah, the one we have to look at the lower time frame. Okay, dia sampai level lah. This is live ah. Ah, nampak. There's a possibility of reversal. Kalau we enter, we are apa ni? Risking around 40-50 pips ya. For now, 40-50 pips. Yeah. This if we go to M1, kita boleh risk maybe around 15 pips. Okay, 15 pips ya. Yeah. If we buy here. Nampak? This is what we do. Kita cari tempat yang like this. Ada order sikit ni. Okay. It might go up from here. Asli, okay? Ah, ini kita mark tadi kan live. And then it bounces up here. For now. If we... There's a reversal here. These three candlestick, M1, sudah buat reversal, So if kalau dia mau pull back for now, for scalpers, yes, M1 easily around 10-20 pips are here now. This is the what? Nice actually. Short term, because long term dia masih kuat turun. Long term masih kuat turun. Okay, I think we have reached our apa ni end of kita punya kan jam 9 sudah. Okay, cepat juga kan. Okay, our goal is to create and build a system that suit investors punya portfolio. Okay, okay, with the right process and system, you can turn small investment into an achievable wealth. That one memang betul. But you have to know your system. Itu penting itu. Your system. So okay, I see you guys on the Telegram. I think Telegram tomorrow dia orang ada buat announcement. Management have to announce to we shift to another Telegram. Bukan shift, we teleport to another Telegram. Nanti kita announce dalam kita punya chat lah. Okay. So guys, any question so far? Thanks for coming. Hi Alex. Apa kabar Alex? Cucu Pokleh. Hi Grace. Jas. Apa kabar? Mararuns. Makaruns. Trade okay Jas. Trade okay. So far. Hi Sean. Mr. Wilbur. Hi Zuraida, thanks for coming today. Thanks for coming. Okay. No, okay lah. If no setup, tidak perlu trade, just no need to trade. Yeah, market is very hot because diorang apa ni tengah buat positioning kan for the next few days. So a lot of manipulation and ghost apa ni ghost move lah ya yeah. Banyak ghost move lah dia move tanpa ada order, they just want to go up there and take some orders and then do some ghost move better wait. Ha, kita tunggu dekat zone. Sampai zone then we go. Right? Sampai zone like just now onion, yeah. Possible can take some apa ni? Some small tips sana. But higher time frame dia masih turun. Daily ya, daily time frame. Nah, weekly monthly is still up lah. Weekly monthly is still up. Daily is down pullback lah. Okay, so thanks for coming all. Otay ada apa-apa? Any question? Sean okay ya, Sean? Semua okay ya? FX boy okay ya? So far I keep on my, okay, study bagus. Move to demo, okay. All right, then thanks then. Thanks. We will keep update. We will keep update dalam apa ni Telegram. So far there's nothing dalam in the market Monday. As usual, Monday is quite slow lah. Right? Monday is quite slow. EU, okay. As I told you, Sean, go on intraday or go on a short-term positioning. Meaning you can hold your price until the next, maybe if, for instance, kan, Sean, okay, for instance, we look at the chart, go on EU. Wow, price go down. Okay. Okay, you are buying now, kan? Say, for instance, you're buying now, kan? Okay, hold on, go to M4. What time frame are you playing, Sean? What time frame? M15. Yo. M15. Okay, if you go M15, man, we have to go M15 then. Nah, yeah, EO is going up, kan? We are in a buy zone, dia tengah pull up. There's a reversal, nampak combo? Sean? Yeah, but do you see the MOAR? See this? Ah, yes. This is a beautiful one. Dia dalam time frame besar. Okay. It's making what? It's making MOAR. Silap pula. Hold on. Blue. Yes, this is the one. Nah, itu pasal dia tengah reverse tu tadi. I think some of you will understand this already lah. This double combo ah. 1, 2, form this up. So if you take M15 ah, M15 rules of thumb kan, if you scalp there, seems like scalping lah. This is your zone. But if you want to hold because we are from a buy zone kan, you go to H1. Find the next one. Okay, this it will stop here for a while. It will stop there. If you're buying from down there just now, you just monitor in it. It will stop somewhere here. Yes. Kalau dia tembus cantik. Kalau no, you just put BE here. If no, it will might probably come down here for more apa ni liquidity before it go up. Okay. Got it lah. Okay. So this is a nice bounce back lah. This is nice bounce. It might stop here for a while lah. For now. Tapi kalau dia kuat turun, but look at the US index. Look at the US index. Because if we look at US index sekarang, deh bounces back, bounces down from the sell zone sudah kan? Yes, it bounces down from the sell zone already. It have to clear the what? Boleh Otay, nanti kita jumpa Otay. Lepas MCO. Selepas MCO. Okay, so we see ya. Live nampak ah? Bounces up ah. Dia bounce dari sini ya. Sell zone. This is our sell zone kita sudah mark ah. Dia sampai juga 9300. Oh, just nice lah 9300. Did you look at this, Sean, just now? Yes, that's good. That's good. Yeah, I was doing class. I was doing live, so cannot. But my POs are all there. My POs are all there. Some other PO. Okay. Anyway, thanks for coming all. Jadi kita nampak nih, kita monitor ah. Ini cantik nih. Actually, this one bounce, and then we look at the kita tengok Euro USD pun tengah bounce. Seems like it's going up, Sean. Seems like it's going up. This is the first structure that it have to break. Kalau dia break ini, Sean, if it breaks here, then it's much more easier for it to continue. Fancy, yeah, Sean. This is the structure that it have to break. This one. Meaning, up, break this, down, baru up. This is a lower time frame structure lah. But it's nice to catch from here. Cantik lah, Sean catch from here, cantik. Okay, I think time's up 9:30 sudah. So kita tengok. Okay, nampak ah? They bounce ah from this ah. So 9300 is one of our kita punya level yang kita monitor for bounce. Cantik, memang cantik. Saya pun tengok dia 9300 somewhere there. And another two more here. Because there's a few more days kan. Mungkin dia mungkin akan naik pergi ambil liquidity lagi before it go down. That's all. Which BB zone ah? Zone Sean? The Euro USD kah? Back the busy zone, sorry. Yes. This is the structure that it have to break first. Okay, that's the first structure in the lower time frame. Now this one he used up already. This one, this cell also not so much because this cell is where, cell is in the busy zone. Yeah, as you know, dalam busy zone tidak kuat. Okay, that one we all know lah. Break ah, this break then ada harapan naik. But we have to wait for this. Wah kuat oh, nice oh kuat, very nice. So okay ah. So I see you guys next week. Yang ada pergi kelas, join kelas next month, early of the month can join kelas kan? Time MCO ni we can study more. You welcome, Sean. You welcome. Zuraida, thanks for coming. Alex, thank you for coming, Alex. CP, thanks. Hi Grace. See you around. Macarons, papai, thank you ah. Okay, Wilbur, also thank you. Haha. Nanti Astri, nanti kita we chat more on that. Okay. Alright, see you guys. Ngam-ngam 9:30. Alright, have a good weekend. See you guys in the Telegram. Alright, thanks. Good night. Good night. Good night all.
Good night. Good night. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Welcome. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Fifu. Selamat malam.
Selamat malam, Zuraida.